This time I'm going to present our exhibition of the acculturation model from our second language acquisition subject of the education career in the Federico Villarreal University. Description. Schumann defines the acculturation model as a process of a social and psychological integration of the second learner with a target language group. It's important to say that this model deals with the learners in society. It means immigrants, but not in formal settings. It means students in classrooms. Schumann holds that acquiring a new language is part of a general process of acculturation. Success is determined by the extent to which they can orient to the target language culture. And when we talk about extent, it means the degree that the learner acculturates to the target language group. So acculturation means moving from one culture to another. Let's see this example. Let's suppose that I am from Peru and my mother tongue is Spanish. In order to improve my English language, for example, I can travel to the USA or to England or to Australia. Why? Because these three countries speak English. That is the target language I want to acquire. This is another example. In the left side, we can see a boy, maybe it's a boy from Peru, living in the USA. And at the right side, we see a boy, maybe from the USA. And this Peruvian boy says, "My native tongue is Spanish, but I speak English at the school." So maybe the parents of this boy have traveled to USA for work, and this boy is learning the English in the USA. One culture group adopting the practices of another culture group is an example of acculturation. What about failure? Schumann says that failure to learn a new language can be explained by two important factors or aspects. Those are social distance and psychological distance between the learner and the target language group. Both distances between the learner and the mainstream culture will determine the rate of language acquisition or acculturation. The social factors are 8. And when we talk about social factor, it means to become part of the target language group. These 8 factors are integration pattern, number 2 enclosure, 3 social dominance, 4 cohesiveness, 5 size, 6 cultural congruence, 7 intended length of residence, 8 attitude toward the new culture. Let's explain. Integration pattern. It means adaptations to the lifestyle and values of the target culture. The two cultures must be well integrated. Less integration between two cultures, more distance and difficult to learn to acquire the target language. Number 2, enclosure. It means interaction with members of the target culture. For example, they share interaction in clubs, profession, recreational facilities. It has to do with social facilities. More integration is less distance and better. Number 3, size. It is related to the learner formed communities in the target culture. A larger learner group, more distance with the target group. But the smaller the learner group, the more likely to contact with the target group and more suitable conditions for second language acquisition. Number 4, social dominance. It's related to the perceived status of a group in relation to another. If it is culturally, politically, socially, economically superior or inferior over the target language, there might be resistance in learning the target language. So it means there would be more social distance. But if both groups are equal in status, it means less social distance, there will be better conditions to learn. Number five, cohesiveness. It means make relationships with native speakers and stay together in a group with similar traits. It is how tiny you are with the target culture group. It is intra-group contacts. It's how you join to the target group. The more you cohesive to the culture group, less social distance and better conditions to learn. Number six, cultural congruence. Very different culturally increase the distance. For example, between the culture of USA and the India. There are many differences, so the interaction increases. But when we have two countries with that are similar culturally, the distance is smaller and better to learn the language. For example, between USA and United Kingdom, there are more similarities. So, if the two groups have cultural values that are very similar, it's easy to learn the new language. Number seven, intended length of residence. This is how long the learner is intended to stay in the target language country. If the learner plans to stay for a long time, it is a decrease or less distance. And number eight, attitude. We have to make positive attitudes toward the culture target group. It means decrease the distance. Negative attitude, increase the distance. Now let's see about the psychological factors. We have three: motivation, culture shock, and attitude. And when we talk about psychological factors, it means how comfortable a learner is in relation to the surrounding social. Is the individual response to the conditions. It has to do with emotions or feelings. Let's see number one, motivation. Is the extent that learners are integratively or instrumentally motivated to learn. For example, you are motivated because you get a new job, or you are really interested in learning the language. High motivation, more likely to learn the language target. It means less distance. Number two, culture shock. It's how the learner experiments stress, anxiety, or fear when entering to the new culture. Less culture shock or distance, more likely to learn the language target. And number three, attitude. Learner recognizes differing worldviews and adopt a positive and open-minded attitude toward cross-cultural differences. So if you have positive attitudes, more likely to learn. It means less distance. Let's see another example. This is Maria, and she is from Mexico. What happened with her? She had less social distance with a target language group. Other factors were that her boss was a white man, there was no integration between both cultures, all co-workers were Mexican and spoke Spanish, negative attitudes toward the target language group. So at the end, she didn't learn the English language. But by the contrary, let's see Emmanuel's case. Emmanuel also was from Mexico, and he had less social distance. Why? Because at the school, he interacted with a diverse group of students and teachers. There were lots of integration at the school with all cultures, needs to interact with the students and teachers to learn, and he had positive attitude towards the target language group. At the end, Emmanuel learned the English language and he succeeded. Finally, let's see the conclusion. To conclude, it can be seen that many theories and ideas exist around second language acquisition. While there are certainly advantages and disadvantages to each theory, there is no one theory that seems to have all the answers. It can be seen that there are various aspects to each theory that seem to come together to form a number of possible factors that assist people in becoming fluent English speakers or in any other language. Thanks for watching.